Right, Aki Karim here for BBTV. I'm here with Dirty Derry Matthews, who is here for the weigh-in for your fighter Jay Farrell, who's in a good competition tomorrow. And he's drawn a difficult fight in the first one, but it's an interesting one, really interesting one.
Yeah, listen, it's anyone's competition, everyone knows. It's an opportunity for everyone, but at the same time, I'd rather have the favourite in your first fight. And Jay stayed up back a few weeks ago before the competition, when the competition was first announced and when the lineup was introduced, that he'd rather have Zorro being the most experienced in it first. And he's got what he wished for. We've been doing a good camp, everything's gone well. I've worked on stuff with Jay where I've entered prize fighter twice. It's the same platform, it's the same programme basically, and we've done it good. He's had an excellent camp, his sparring's been spot on, and we just want the fight now, get out of the way for him.
Well, you mentioned there yourself, your own experience in prize fighter, and that could be kind of valuable because you've actually been there and done the shorter format of the game.
Yeah, I've done it, and Jay's an explosive fighter, comes out all guns blazing but smart at the same time. And Liverpool have had a good success in prize fighter. Rocky Fielding, for instance, who was another winner, who's Jay's friend as well, and Martin Murray. And the one, myself, got to the finals. So it's exciting times, and I'm looking forward to tomorrow night.
It's good as well. It's a different variation on the sport that we love. It gives people opportunities. And actually, a lot of these fights, well, all of them are pretty much, they could go either way. So that's the sort of dynamic we want to see in boxing, isn't it? We want to see 50-50 type of fights.
Yeah, no one knows who's going to win. It's a tough ask. Three fights in one night, but if you do it smart and do it clever, you know, you can make it a good night for yourself. And it's just about, you know, Jay being switched on now and having everything, himself, confidence in himself to go out there and do the damage you need at hand.
Now, Derry, what do you make of wider boxing at the minute? Are you still sort of keeping up with it from a day-to-day basis? I know you're busy with your coaching and everything like that, but you still keep up with things from day-to-day?
Yeah. Listen, I'm boxing's in my blood. I've got a successful amateur boxing club. And I've got a good little pro stable as well, so we're working hard. Me and myself, Michael Jennings, who's the other coach with me in the gym. You know, me and him, we're basically running things from day to day with each other. Tomorrow, he's got to take two kids down to the national championships down in Bradbury. Down in Bradbury, the schoolboy championships are down there. Geno's going to be in there with them, and then head up here for the night time with me and Jay, and then we're all going to head back down to Bradbury. So it's exciting times for us and as a club.
It's great times for you at the minute. It's good times for Liverpool boxing as well. Liam Smith just had a really good win away, didn't he?
Unbelievable.
Jesse Barnes, he actually looked really good in that. He looked fresh.
Listen, I don't think everyone knows how good Beefy is. He's unbelievable. He's a tremendous fighter. He can do it. And for me, he's most probably, if not him and Tony Bell, I always say Bell is the part being the best boxer we've got in the city, and then, you know, Callum Smith as well is an excellent fighter, but Beefy's got to be, you know, for me, he's just number two below Bellew, the best fighter in the city. I think he's done everything so far of his career, has been excellent. He's boxed the best, he hasn't shied away from no one, and to me, he's the top out there.
What did you make as well of the Fury and White stuff? I mean, Fury talking about retirement now. You yourself as an ex-fighter, an ex-champion, when you get to that stage of your career when people are talking about retirement, can you remember that conversation that you had about retirement and what you think's going through his mind?
Well, there's a difference between a fighter who's got no money retiring and a fighter who's worth millions. Me personally, if I was him, I'd retire. He's got enough money in the bank. He doesn't need any money. He'll go and get a job being a pundit if he needs it. Just live your life, be a happy family man. As he said in his interviews, school runs, changing shitty asses, changing nappies, being a dad. And a lot of people don't see that apart. The other part of boxing where you're missing your family, you're missing your family time, you're missing your banter with the lads, going to the pub, going for food with the boys. People don't see that. It's just all about boxing. And be a family man now. That's what, if I was him, that's what I'd be. Just be a family man, and that's the best way you can be.
You know, still though, when you do retire, like, do you actually remember back when you retired? In the few months after you retired, did you get itchy feet and were you, or itchy knuckles, as they say?
No, because I always knew where my path was going. I always had my gym and my amateur club set up for me, and I knew where what I was going to do. And people always say, I get it all the time, you're going to have another fight, you're going to come back, you're going, do you miss it? No, I don't miss it. I put everything I could into the sport. I loved it. And now I want to put everything into it as a coach. And so I don't miss getting punched. Do I miss getting up in the morning, going running with the lads? No, because I do it as a coach. I take the lads running every morning. We're in the gym early. So I don't miss that part of it. Do I miss the diet? No. No, I don't. There's nothing I miss. And, you know, I'm still involved in the sport. I love the sport. And I've been lucky enough to be a coach.
When you look at people like, for example, Ricky Hatton's making an exhibition comeback and people like that, what do you think? Do you ever think, do you think that's a positive thing for these retired fighters coming back and doing this sort of thing?
I don't get why he's doing it. Ricky, listen, everyone knows why. I mean, everyone knows Ricky Hatton is. He's a superstar. The best fighter the country's ever had, the world's ever had. But I just don't know why he's doing this. So it must be triggering him to do it. So good luck to him.
So you'd never be tempted to do something like that, do a little comeback?
Again, I always say, if the money's right, you're going to fight. And at the same time, Ricky doesn't need money, surely, do you know what I mean? So, do you get me? If someone comes to me now and went, right, I'm going to fight there, £500,000, you're going to fight. But £500,000 to Ricky and actually Fury and them, most probably nothing. But to us other little fighters, it is. So, it's only Ricky can answer that.
Fair enough. Just one final one, Derek, because I know you're very good at breaking down fights, and of course I want to get your insights on this as a coach as well. If you're coaching Anthony Joshua to beat Usyk in the rematch that's going to be announced any day, how do you go about instructing him to do that?
Take a bat. Oh, yeah. Take a bat to me. No, listen, I think Usyk is the best. I just think he's the best, and that's why if I was Fury, I wouldn't want to fight Usyk. I think if styles, it'd be a border fight, wouldn't it? Me personally, I think. But Usyk, it's just...
You think you'd beat Fury as well?
Yeah.
Right.
I do. Just by the style, just the way he is. He can just adapt. He's athletic. I know Fury is, but I just think Usyk's just got something about him where he's an extra bit special.
Fair enough. So you're basically saying, Joshua,
just
is his best thing then to go in there and just try and unload
them
and get him
out
there?
Go in there, all guns blazing, and try and chin him. You're not going to outbox him. Go out there and got to chin him. And don't get me wrong, I think he can do it. I think AJ can absolutely smash anyone with either hand. He's a massive puncher. And take risks. He's got to take risks. As soon as that bell goes, he's got to go, right, I'm going for a fight. If he gets chinned himself, he gets chinned, but he's confident.
Fair enough, mate. Now, I know you've got preparations to do now for your fight with Jay tomorrow. Yeah. And it's going to be explosive, it's going to be exciting. And, fingers crossed, your man can do the business.
Thank you. We are going to. Thank you.